Hey, I'm Kevin Wallace. I am the Director of Forecasting at Surfline, and we are going to look at how to use the buoy spectrograph. The first tool that I check every morning, whether I'm working or not, is the buoys. And part of that is the buoy spectra, and it gives you a great idea of what the surf is doing in my area and if I'm going to surf, where I might try and go surf. There's several different ways you can access buoys on the site, and that's where we're going to access our spectral information too. The easiest way is if you just go to a report page. So if we scroll all the way down, you will see nearby buoys. Click on one of those. So if we scroll down just a little bit more on this Waimea buoy page, we can see our spectrograph right here. One of the first things you'll notice here when you look at the swell spectrograph is you can look at it in either a fixed scale or a non-fixed scale. I like to look at it in a non-fixed scale when I'm on mobile and the fixed scale when I'm on web. Okay, so this is the Waimea Bay buoy, and as I look through this, what I see is a really wide distribution of swell directions and swell periods, energy anywhere from 5 seconds all the way up to around 14 to 15 seconds. When you see that sort of distribution with short, mid, and even longer period energy, that tells me that the surf's probably gonna be pretty mixed up, especially at those spots like pipeline, you know, reefs, point breaks that tend to like a single medium or longer period swell. And as you look up at the camera here, there you go. It just looks kind of mixed up, looks kind of noisy. And for a spot like pipe that prefers, again, like kind of a single longer period swell, it's just not very good. If I saw this and was thinking about the beach breaks, I might think the opposite, actually, where we've got more mixed up surf, but a lot of times that means peakier surf and better surf for the beach break. So it's interesting to look at it in a couple different lenses. And in this case, I would be looking towards beach breaks for the better surf versus points and reefs.
If you want to check out Buoy Swell Spectra on iOS, visit the Explore tab and toggle the buoys. You can also scroll to the bottom of the spot page and click on your local buoy, and that's good on all platforms. You'll find the spectrograph below the latest readings and reported data graph.
As you progress in time as your own personal surf forecaster, that's one of those tools that you'll have in your toolkit and used with some of the other things that are on Surfline really help you score more waves.